Decades ago, Texaco left a mess in the jungles of Ecuador. Texaco is now owned by Chevron Corp. A 20-year legal battle ensued, during which the community won a $9.5 billion judgment in a local court to pay for the cleanup. They've tried to get money from different branches of the company in different countries, among them Argentina, Brazil, and the United States. So far, that hasn't worked. Now they're trying to enforce the judgment in Canada, where Chevron's Canadian branch has lots of property. A project in the oil sands, office towers, gas stations, even outlets of the White Spot burger chain. Chevron refuses to pay. A challenge for the plaintiffs is Canadian corporate law. Chevron argues the case doesn't belong in Canada because the judgment was issued against Chevron's US-based parent company and not the Chevron Canada subsidiary. Chevron Canada is not directly owned by US-based Chevron Corp, but is actually seven steps removed from the corporate parent. Chevron Corp Delaware owns Chevron Investments Inc. Delaware, which owns Texaco Inc. Delaware, which owns Texaco Overseas Holding Incorporated Delaware, which owns Chevron Global Energy Incorporated Delaware, 1946, which owns Chevron Standard Limited Delaware, 1944, which owns Chevron Canada Capital Company Nova Scotia, 1999, which owns Chevron Canada, 1966. So is Chevron Canada connected to the US-based parent company? Here's a test. If I was a low-level underling employee of Chevron Canada and I tweeted something really nasty about the boss of the US-based parent company, would I be able to keep my job? I'm Drew Hasselback for the Financial Post.